My name is Olena Mamykina. I'm an assistant professor here with the Department of Biomedical Informatics at Columbia University. We are working on a variety of different diseases over here, specifically interested in using data and information to come up with new scientific knowledge, new medical knowledge. A lot of my work happens outside of the hospital, working with people who manage their chronic conditions. I work with people with type 1 and type 2 diabetes. In general, I'm working with people who are interested in preserving and improving their health and the learning more about healthy behaviors. I'm originally from the former Soviet Union. I was born very, very far north in what's now the Russian Federation. So the first time I crossed polar circle was actually going south. It was a very interesting environment. I was surrounded by shipbuilding industry. It was a northern fleet was there, and the town itself was basically a shipbuilding yard. My background is in computer science. I went to college in the Ukraine in a shipbuilding university. Where I grew up and how I was raised led me to, I think, become a bit of a combination of an engineer and a scientist. So as an engineer, you always look for opportunities to improve the world around you, build bridges, build roads. But as a scientist, you also try to generalize between different problems and not look at them as isolated single problems, but to look for connections between them and what makes one problem similar to another. And that's how you come up with more generalized knowledge for a whole class of different problems. When I was still working on my master's, that I started noticing things that I'm just really, really passionate about and interested in. What I was always interested in is finding ways to use technology to help people make their own choices. We don't apply the same treatment to everybody because people are very different from each other. There are no two people with the same disease exactly in the same form. So I think there is more and more attention to finding personalized solutions.
One thing I can tell you is that
I'm actually very rarely here. I spend most of my time visiting community health centers around New York, working with people with chronic diseases, interviewing them, conducting focus groups. Again, trying to understand why is it difficult? What makes it so challenging to have diabetes? And then we design prototypes of systems that can improve something in people's lives and how they engage in health and healthcare. Right now, I'm overseeing a relatively large randomized control trial. We're recruiting 240 individuals with diabetes in New York, and we're giving them this application. They're using it for 4 weeks, and we're trying to see whether or not it has an impact on their diabetes self-management.
Yeah.
Success as a scientist depends on your ability to never stop learning. Every day learn something that we don't know what it means and how to explain it.
It's really nice. This is not the best.
I like the academic freedom. I like to not have to basically respond to anybody and set my own ideas and work on the problems that I find interesting. And seeing the real change. Seeing when people use my applications, my solutions, and they tell me, this was the best thing since sliced bread, my goodness, look at my blood glucose numbers. I've never seen numbers like that. That was a really groundbreaking several weeks for me. Now I feel for the first time that I'm finally in control of my disease. That makes not only day, but that makes my year when we hear things like that, and it does happen.
Okay. more.
So, I mean, we have this process here that are kind of doing the same.
Yeah, because what I would recommend, just keep each of these clusters, put them somehow together, because we're going to be writing that paper soon.
Right.
But so we'll see.
We'll see. Okay.